Good morning, guys. So today we have some knives for sharpening. This is a knife from Global. The serial calls Global SAI. This is a chef around 20 centimeters. I have one more chef, pretty long one, around 25-30 centimeters. Pretty heavy knife. Then one more Santoku from the same series. And then one more utility knife, around 150 millimeters. They're pretty thick. They have a hammer pattern. The steel, I'm not sure what the steel is inside. It says that it's in cloth, in stainless cloth. So I guess I'm not sure. Not sure what kind of steel is it. For now, please write in the comments. Will be interesting to know. I have sharpened already a few knives from this series. I will say that it's not my favorite steel to work with, but it's okay. It's manageable. Here I have a stone sharpened glass, number 120. Already sharpened with him about maybe 10 knives or something like that. And I have to say, it's still in a good condition. Yes, in some places gets uneven, but it's much more harder stone than I expected. It's, I don't know, it's probably 10 times harder than the Sharpton Xerox. From Sweet Hero Xerox. So I'm very impressed with this stone, and I really like it. I really like this stone. So in the future, I'm thinking to buy some more of the Sharpton glass stone, because I think they are really good quality. And they doesn't wash so fast as other stones. So probably this top, which is only half centimeter, will work longer for you than this stone from Xerox. This is 320 stone. And I already, it's been a little bit higher. So I spent maybe 10 knives on this stone, and I can see that it's washing so fast away comparing to the Sharpton glass. So at the moment, Sharpton glass for me is the best of the harder stones, with the core stones. All right, so let me show you the knife before we're gonna start it. Let me show you that it maybe cut something. Oh, maybe not. Well, yeah, it does, but not so good. So here we have some damage on the knife. The edge, to be honest, looks pretty fine. There is some chips, there is some small places where it's missing a metal, but it's not so much. So I think I'm just gonna make a new edge first, and then we're jumping on a stone number 1000. And happy days. Alright, so let's start, guys. Sharpton glass number 120. I'm gonna use the H is about I'm gonna keep the H is about maybe 15 degrees, something like that. I think I need some lights, can't see so much. So we're gonna sharpen one side until we don't get a bar all the way in the whole length of the blade. I can feel already bar here most of the places, but I can see some chips which I have to go a little bit more, a little bit more deeper, I would say. Alright, now I can feel the bar all over the knife, in the full length of the blade. Alright, now we can feel it all over. So it means that we can change the side now. I can show you how the edge looking now. I'll have a look. That's one side. And we have a bar on this side. So now we're gonna jump to another side. Yes, now I can feel the bar from another side too. And that means that we are ready to go for another side. So bar is here. Yes. So here is the 1000 from the King. And we're going for this side now. Just like need a little bit water. When you see that stone is asking for water, just add some more. When you feel that feelings are different during a sharpening. So I'm keeping the edge is about 15 degrees, still the same. And I keep it during the all sharpening, the same angle. So we can have a nice white edge, which is gonna be very visible and of course sharp. Так, so. I'm checking for the bar and I can feel the bar all over the blade for the full length, from the top till the end of the blade, till the handle. That's how looking the edge now. Please have a look. Alright, and now I'm jumping to another side. A little bit of water. Alright, so now we're checking again for the bar, and I can feel it. So, now will be the stone number 3000. I think I need to build one more holder like this. It was pretty easy, and maybe if I make one more, then I don't have to change so often the stones. So I can just install one stone on one holder and have it basically forever under. So okay. This is the stone number 3000. I'm gonna use a little bit Nagura. Water, and we start sharpening the side which have a bar. Smooth moves, you don't have to push on a stone, just keep the same angle as you did before. The stone will do all the work. You can see how much actually metal it's eating, so black. So stone does the sharpening, all you need is just a little bit passion and make it even from the tip to the handle. So we're checking for the bar again, and I can feel the bar all over. So that means we can switch the side again. Let's do it. A little bit more water. All right. So guys, let's make a first test after the stone number 3000. Let me show you also how the edge look like. So, have a look. That's how our edge look like after the stone number 3000, after 120,000 and 3000. Looks pretty white and good. So a small test, of course. It does cutting, but not so good as I wish. Well, of course, I still have a bar on one side, which could be removed. I think it needs a little bit more on the top, just a little bit more. Now I'm removing the bar. Okay. So, another small test. Yes, now it goes much more smoother, for sure. So, let's grab the high stone with the high grit and let's finish this knife. So, here is the stone number 6000 and 10000. One of my favorite, I call it soapy stone because it feels like a soap on it. Very slippery. So yes, super fine stone number 6000, and let's polish a little bit the edge. So it needs a little bit more. Okay, and let's go for another side. After this tone, the H is already start to be shiny. I really like this feeling when the knife's becoming, like, I'll say new. The H is shiny, so it gives the fact that knife just came from the industry. It just been made. So let's have a look, guys. Let's clean it a little bit up and let's have a look. So you can see, yeah, after the 6000, the H is already becoming pretty shiny. Fantastic. Looks really great. That's another side. Isn't it cool? Alright, let's have another small test. Well, on my feeling it does the cutting really well. But of course, this is not the finish yet. So now I would love to polish it on leather. I'm gonna skip the 10,000, but I'm gonna use the leather. So side number one. Find the comfortable position first. Then let's jump on the other one. This is with the green paste, with the, in Russian it calls pasta goya. But you probably know what I mean. It's a green paste, I think it's like, you can find it all over the world. It's the one for polishing. Green or ouch paste calls, I think, another way as well. You'll find it, guys. Yeah, for the one who haven't like our videos, please do it now. Also, don't forget to subscribe on the channel. That will help us to grow. And also, maybe you want to give some advice what kind of video you would love to see next. There was once one of the subscribers asked to do a video about some special knives, and we did it because it's great for us. We don't have to think what kind of video to create. So if you give some ideas, we're probably gonna do it. So please do it. Don't be shy. And at the same time, you will help us to don't spend time on the thinking what kind of video to create. So have a look now, guys. Just look at that beauty. That's how our H look like. So I will say this is a brand new knife with the new shiny H, pretty long one. Looks fantastic, isn't it? Well, one thing is that it looks fantastic. It also have to cut fantastic. All right. So now we're gonna test if it does. If it does cutting fantastic. So here I have a regular magazine, regular paper. Let's do the test. Here you go, buddy. Goes pretty easy and smooth. In the full length of the blade. I really like the way it's the paper is falling down. Yes, the knife is sharp. It's really sharp. So let's do a small last test on a toilet paper. Just a second. So here we got toilet paper. It's a 3 layers of toilet paper. So let's have a look if it's gonna cut it. And it does. Of course it does. The knife is sharp. So if it cuts the toilet paper, then it means it's cutting pretty much everything. Here you go, guys. So yes. One more time. This is how our global SAI look like after the repairing, after the sharpening. I think the result is really good. Got toilet paper. It's 3 layers of toilet paper. So let's have a look if it's gonna cut it. And it does. Of course it does. The knife is sharp. So if it cuts the toilet paper, then it means it's cutting pretty much everything. Here you go, guys. So yes. One more time. This is how our global SAI look like after the repairing, after the sharpening. I think the result is really good. The edge is shiny. Looks awesome. The knife is sharp. And I'm happy too. So yes. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to put like and subscribe on the channel. Video we are making every one, two video every week. So subscribe and don't forget to put the bell to be updated all the time. So when the new video is coming up, you can see the notice about it. So yeah, with you was Andrei, Original Knives, and thank you for watching. See ya.